Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can use the jColor Chooser class in Java to color components. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Okay, let's get started, everybody. So we're going to be discussing the jColor Chooser class. This is a GUI mechanism that lets a user choose a color. So here's an example of my setup. I have two classes, a class called main that contains my main method, and a new instance of my other class called myframe. So myframe extends JFrame and implements the action listener interface. I have a constructor called myframe. Within the constructor, I have this.setDefaultClose operation, JFrame exit on close. I'm using a new flow layout, followed by this.pack and this.setVisibleToTrue. I also have an action performed method for when we click on a button, we're going to change either the background color or the font color of a label. So let's declare a button and a label. So let's declare these outside of the constructor so that they're globally available to our action performed method. So we'll create a J button, let's call this button, as well as a label. So J label called label. And then we will finish instantiating these within the constructor. So button equals new J button, and I'm going to set some text right away just by passing in a string to the constructor of the J button. I will say pick a color. All right, let's create a label. So that is label equals new J label, but this has to be capital. Okay, I'm also going to set the background color. So label.setBackground, and then we can pick a color, maybe just white. So color.white. So in order to display the background color, we need to set opaque true. So set opaque, and we're going to pass in true. Let's also set some text and the font. So label.setText. This is some text. Good enough. Let's also change the font too, because this is going to be fairly small. So label.setFont, and we can pass in a new font. Pick whatever font you want. I will pick one of my favorites, which is MV Boli. You can style this. I'm just going to set this to plain, and then a size. I want something massive like 100. And that's all there is to it. Oh, then we have to add an action listener to this button. So button.addActionListener. And I'm going to pass in this because we're implementing the action listener interface. And then we need to add this button and this label to the frame. So this.add, we're going to add the button followed by the label. So this.add label. Then we should be good. All right, so all we have is a button and then some text. This is our label. So when we click on our button, we're going to launch a new instance of our jColor chooser. So if e.getSource is equal to our button, then we're going to declare and instantiate a new color chooser. So in order to do that, we're going to declare jColor chooser, and we will call this instance color chooser, or whatever you want, equals new jColor chooser. So this will create a new instance of our jColor chooser, but we need to create a dialog box. So we can actually assign that to a new color, whatever this returns. So color, we'll call this color, equals jColor chooser dot show dialog. So for the arguments, this takes a parent component, a title, and an initial color. So for the parent component, we're just going to set this to null because we don't have one. We can set a title, so pick a color, I guess. And then an initial color, like what do you want the default to be? So I'll just say color.black. So this will create a dialog for us, and when we run this and click on our button to pick a color, it's going to open this menu, and it has our title, pick a color, I guess. Okay, so we can pick a color, and we can click OK. This has a few other options too. I don't really know what this crap is, but feel free to mess with these settings. So let's say I want the screen color, then I click OK. Well, we have this color stored within our color, called color, coincidentally. Now, we need to actually change the color of whatever it is we want to color. So let's change the foreground color of our label first. So label.setForeground, that's the font color, and we're going to pass in our color that we select. So now when we run this, and we pick a color, let's say I want that green color again, I think it was something like that, and click OK, it's now going to change the foreground color. We can also change the background color too, of whatever component that we want. So I'm going to change the background of our label, so label.setBackground, and we're going to pick that color again. So let's pick, I don't know, pink. And the background is now pink. So you don't necessarily have to do this with labels, you can do this with all sorts of components, but a label is kind of convenient just because you can add text to a label and you can also change the background color. Well, that's the very basics of the JColorChooser class. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of the JColorChooser class in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.